Air Force and Lockheed Martin have developed several new weapons for the F-22 Raptor to equip the stealth fighter with more long-range precision attack technology, a wider targeting envelope or field of regard, and new networking technology enabling improved, real-time collaborative targeting between aircraft. The two new weapons, which have been under testing and development for several years now, are advanced variants of existing weapons, the AIM-9X air-to-air missile and the AIM-120D. Upgraded variants of each are now operational. The new AIM-9X will shoot farther and reach a much larger targeting envelope for pilots. Working with a variety of helmets and display systems, Lockheed developers have added off-foresight targeting ability, enabling pilots to attack enemies from a wide range of new angles. Raytheon AIM-9X weapons developers have informed that the Block 2 variant adds a redesigned fuel and digital ignition safety device that improves ground handling and in-flight safety. Block 2 also features updated electronics, enabling significant upgrades, including the ability to lock on after launch using a new weapon data link to support beyond visual range combat, said a Raytheon statement. Another part of the weapon's upgrade includes engineering the F-22 to fire the AIM-120D, a beyond visual range advanced medium range air-to-air missile, AMRAAM, designed for all-weather day and night attacks. It is a fire-and-forget missile with active transmit radar guidance, Raytheon data states. The AIM-120D is built with upgrades to previous AMRAAM missiles by increasing attack range, GPS navigation, inertial measurement units, and a two-way data link, Raytheon statements explain. As the Air Force and Lockheed Martin move forward with weapons envelope expansions and enhancements for the F-22, there is of course a commensurate need to upgrade software and its onboard sensors to adjust to emerging future threats, industry developers explained. Ultimately, this effort will lead the Air Force to draft up requirements for new F-22 sensors. The F-22 lethality is also getting vastly improved through integration of new two-way link 16 data link connectivity between aircraft, something which will help expedite real-time airborne collaborative targeting. Having a digital ability to transmit fast-changing, combat-relevant targeting information from an F-22 cockpit without needing voice radios lessens the risk associated with more jammable or hackable communications. Newer F-22s have a technology called Synthetic Aperture Radar, or SAR, which uses electromagnetic signals or pings to deliver a picture or rendering of the terrain below, allowing better target identification. The SAR technology sends a ping to the ground and then analyzes the return signal to calculate the contours, distance, and characteristics of the ground below. The F-22 is also known for its Super Cruise technology, which enables the fighter to reach speeds of Mach 1.5 without needing to turn on its afterburners. This enables the fighter to travel faster and farther on less fuel, a scenario which expands its time for combat missions. The fighter jet fires a 20mm cannon and has the ability to carry and fire all the air-to-air and air-to-ground weapons, including precision-guided ground bombs, such joint direct attack munitions called the GBU-32 and GBU-39. It also uses what's called a radar warning receiver, a technology with an updatable database called mission data files designed to recognize a wide range of enemy fighters, much like the F-35. Made by Lockheed Martin and Boeing, the F-22 uses two Pratt & Whitney F-119 PW100 turbofan engines with afterburners and two-dimensional thrust vectoring nozzles, an Air Force statement said. It is 16 feet tall, 62 feet long, and weighs 43,340 pounds. Its maximum takeoff weight is 83,500. F-22 and F-A-18. The need for a carrier-based fighter like the F-22 clearly did exist. For years leading up to and after the arrival of the F-35C, the Navy consistently sought to acquire more Block 3 Super Hornet F-A-18 aircraft. Yearly Navy budgets in 2013, 2014, and 2015 consistently placed a sizable amount of F-18s on the unfunded priorities list, something which showed the need for a new platform or bridge to extend sea-launched air attack until the F-35C could become operational in the early 2020s. While the F-18 is a combat-proven, reliable platform, which has been massively upgraded over the years, it is by no means stealthy. Therefore, a stealthy fighter jet such as a Navy variant of the F-22 for carrier attack would certainly expand the power projection possibilities for carrier air wings. A maritime F-22 would have offered a high-speed air superiority complement to the F-18 and F-35C. The question this raises is, would such a development have further delayed the F-A-XX program currently in development, should a maritime variant of the F-22 exist? The F-22 may be regarded as the most preeminent air superiority platform the world has ever seen, yet the high-profile Raptor almost became a new bomber platform. B-52, B-1B, and B-2 bomber fleet. In the challenging time during the height of the Cold War in the 1980s, there was no shortage of a need for stealth and integrated air attack given the threat posed by the Soviet Union. There was not only a need to elude advanced Soviet-designed air defenses, but also to exact a catastrophic effect quickly to cripple an enemy. At the time, the B-52 had run its course over several decades and had not yet been upgraded to the extent it is today. The B-2 Spirit had been cut short. Perhaps this means that the Pentagon sought to address the bomber deficit created by the decision to truncate B-2 production and massively reduce anticipated fleet size. The Cold War was nearing, and at the time it may have seemed as though there was less of a need for a high-end stealth bomber such as the B-2. Newly intensified U.S.-Russian tensions in the 1990s following the collapse of the Soviet Union may have resurrected the belief in a need for a larger stealth bomb attack fleet, a circumstance that may have inspired thinking to adapt the emerging 1990s-era F-22 as a new bomber. At the same time, however, there was a pressing need to make efforts to stay in front of the Russian Su-27 and Chinese J-10. The considerations of a bomber platform for the F-22 point to a bomber fleet deficit the Air Force is seeking to correct today.